You got a place to live, you got a car, you got some wheels on it, you got some gas to drive and stress enough to start it up. God is worthy of all my praise. Amen. I'm going to Hallelujah Square because what my name is on the Lamb's Book of Life. To help me preach. You know you can help me preach. All you got to do is look at me and smile and say amen. And if you look at me like you want to fight, you pick a fight with somebody else. I just don't feel like fighting this morning. But check with me after church, after I get something to eat. We go outside, amen. I might go a couple rounds with you. But right now, I want to tell you what the Lord said. I want to tell you about the goodness of the Lord and all He's done for me. My soul cries out. Yeah. 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 I tell you what I do though.
Well.
We used to do it when we was kids. We put a stick on our shoulder.
All right.
I said, I dug a day, you just knock it off. So what I'm going to tell you today, I dug a day. Accept Jesus as your Savior. The other day you're to praise and worship Him today. Amen. Now take me up on my challenge. And I guarantee you God will do what He said He would do. Is everybody happy to be here? Amen. Amen. You ought to be happy. Because God, whatever God do for us, He don't have to do it. Amen. Amen. He don't have to do it. So, amen. And once you say, He don't say no stuck up folk. He don't say no stuck up funny acting looking folk. Come on, talk to me. Amen. Exactly. When God saved us, He put joy in us. Amen. Joy will make you say something when you don't want to say it. Joy will make you, amen, will speak when you don't want to speak. Joy will make you love when you don't want to love. Joy will make you pray for your enemy and you know they can't stand your guts. God will make you do it anyhow. Amen. I'm happy. The Lord woke me up and Miss English at church. Amen. She's about the same age as my mama and still got a sharp mind. Hey, Rabbi. I want you to know, Miss English, you lift my spirit. Because, amen, you're in your seat. That's the seat you've been sitting in 28 years. Amen. I believe everybody else is afraid to sit in. And they'll say that in his English seat. Come on, laugh with me a little bit. Amen. There is a word from the Lord, but we honor Him first in your presence. Amen. And to these ministers of the gospel. Amen. We call them fellow sufferers. Because if you think you get called and don't suffer for the sake of the gospel,
all right,
you might as well leave it alone.
Amen.
To the officers and deacons of this church, amen, my brothers and sisters in Christ, minister's wife and to the best wife in the world, Sister Henderson, amen. It's good to be in your presence one more time. If you send to a neighbor that you want to say amen, your neighbor don't want to say amen, when you get ready to say amen, just tell them, excuse me. Because I just can't sit here and not see nothing. Because God has been too good to me. Isn't that right? You're going through something, amen. That means what? God got you. Because you're still moving right on through it. Isn't that right? Amen. The Bible said we've been enduring for a night. But joy comes in the morning. You just got to hold to God's unchanging hand. Because our hand may change, but God's hand never changes. Isn't that right? We had a wonderful week. Amen. All Sunday. Amen. Remember to worship. Amen. Monday. Can't nobody turn me around. Amen. I got my notes. Amen. I don't remember all that, but I got my notes. Amen. Tuesday. Amen. Time to make a decision. Amen. That remember to worship, that was spread. Monday. Amen. Reverend Carson Kane. Can't nobody turn me around. We're talking about the son and daughter of Shady. Tuesday, man, Reverend Hardy said, time to make a decision. Wednesday, amen, Reverend Ashley said, God specializes. Thursday, amen, Reverend Lee said, me and my house, and he said, a group of grace. Friday, Reverend McKinney came and said, God don't change. Saturday, amen, the only dollar we got, amen, said, all in or all out. Amen. Here we go today. Amen. So if you had all that all week, all I need to do is read a scripture and somebody ought to be hollering, saying, thank you, Lord. There was a word, the gospel recorded by St. John and Joshua the 24th chapter. Amen. I don't know how much I'm going to preach about it, but I'm going to deal with it. The Lord said the same, John 15. It's not too much trouble. I want you to stand. If it's trouble, I still want you to stand. Amen. Only those that are not able to stand, it's all right for you to sit. Amen. The gospel is recorded by St. John. I want you to say amen if you have found it. Amen. If you need time to Google it, go ahead. Amen. If you want to pull out your phone, just make sure you're reading the word and not playing a game. Come on, and texting nobody. Amen. You ought to be on John number 15. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. The word says in John 15, the first chapter, said, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman.
Amen.
Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that bear fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit.
All right.
Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine. No more can ye except ye abide in me. I am the vine, and ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bring forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch, and is withered, and gather them, and men gather them, and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. Verse 7 said, if ye abide in me, and my word abide in you, ye shall ask ye will what you will, and it shall be done unto you. In case you didn't know you had that kind of power and authority, I just remind you, if you're in the blessing line, all you got to do is ask God for what you need. Am I right about it? Joshua, amen, 24:15 said, if it seem evil to you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom you will serve. Whether it be the gods of your fathers, serve that they were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites, in whom land ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. God, we pray now that you would use this your servant to your glory, that your word will be further clarified. God, these our people today would be edified. But most of all, God, you be glorified. Use us, give us preaching power to declare your word. And God, when you finish, we'll be careful to give you the praise. In the name of Jesus, we pray in every heart, say amen.
Amen.
Say amen again.
Amen.
Say amen again.
Amen.
I am happy. I am excited about the Lord. I am excited, amen, that he looked beyond my faults. He saw my need. I am excited that he saved a wretch like me. I am excited, amen, that God is a good God. Amen. And Bible said, amen, they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. If you came looking for a blessing, God will give you just what you need. Don't make me work hard.
Come on, Pastor.
And you just sit there looking.
All right.
Let's work hard together.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Amen.
Amen. We told you what the other ministers have preached.
Well.
It's been a blessing all week long.
Amen.
I will give out the grades, court cards a little later.
Yeah.
Amen. But you already know what you got. Isn't that right? But it is such a blessing Amen. First of all, to be saved.
Amen.
It's a blessed privilege.
Yes.
That God, I didn't die in my sin. I received him as my Savior. So if I die, amen, today, I know where I'm going. What do you say, message from the Lord, from these scriptures that the family connected to Jesus? And then subtopic would be me and my God. Me and my God. Amen. I don't know about you, but me and my God, we got something going on. Me and my God are connected. And we got the connection through his son. His son name is Jesus the Christ. For his son said that I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me. Amen. Just say amen at the end of the sentence. If you agree with me, say amen. If I'm in the book, say amen. Because amen is biblical word. Am I right about it? Amen. The family connected to Jesus. And I found out that anybody connected to Jesus is always going to be some good come out of that connection. It always going to be some good fruit. Because you're connected to the vine. Do I have a word? And one thing about knowing the Lord. The Bible said that all things work together for good. For those who love the Lord. And those who are called according to his purpose. So since I gave Jesus my life, when he wake me up in the morning, I know it's going to be a good day. Because what? Amen. I'm connected to him. And not only does he bless me, he blesses my family. In fact, he blessed everything that I put my hand on. Because, amen, I've been called by God. Amen. I'm connected to Jesus the Christ. And not only am I connected, I got the best connection. Amen. Some folk think they got a connection because they got a certain job and they got a certain position or they live in a certain place. Let me remind you today that when you are connected with the Lord, you got the best connection. Amen. You can talk to him about anything and he won't tell nobody. You can talk to him, amen, when things are going well, when things are not going so well, because what? You are connected. And when you're connected with him, the word said, weeping may endure for night, but my help is on the way. My help is. Amen. Let me preach a little while. Amen. When our peoples or when our families are brought back, amen, to this land as slaves.
All right, all right.
The motive of the slave masters were to cut them off from all links, amen, with their pads, so that they would, amen, would feel alone and free. Let me tell you something, amen. Satan will have you feeling like your parents don't love you. He'll have you feeling like nobody cares about you. Am I right about it? But when he tried to do that to me, I reminded that I am a friend in Jesus. And all of our sins and greed to bear, I can talk to him about it. Not a friend we have in Jesus. But when somebody trying to control you, they want to make you feel that nobody else cares about you. When somebody's trying to pull you out of Shady Grove, they're going to make you think that